Hello and welcome back to SaliHughesBeauty.com. This is part two of In the Bathroom with Hirons, except not in the bathroom.
I love the way you just call me Hirons. My first name's Caroline, just an FYI.
We call each other the Hirons and the Hughes, I should say that from the top. If you are at this video and it's your first port of call, you need to go back because you've missed part one. Part one will have already run, so you might want to catch up there before you come here. But for now, we are downstairs in the basement of Caroline's house. See how it's
a bit
Caroline
dark.
Then. And before we even look at the rest of the product, we thought it would be good for you to look at the cleansers because Caroline's obsessed with cleanser. I'm obsessed with cleanser. We both are obsessed with cleansing. So Caroline has an entire stash just of cleansers, which I thought you might want to watch. And you may even catch sight of some Tenor Lady, some Tampax, some
look,
Detox.
I'm sorry. I love Mary Greenwell and Charlotte Tilbury and Val Garland, but them do not have 27 people in their house. And yes, we have the odd Tenor Lady and a Tampax in full view.
Thus.
And also some Elnett and some bin bags, and I don't know what that is, and some Dettol and some carpet cleaner and some nail polish remover. So, you know, I just like to be prepared for every eventuality.
And some shagging dogs.
Where? Oh, they're from, that's a confiscated toy, clearly.
Oh, no, it's a three-headed dog. It's headbrush.
Let's just get rid of that, it's fine.
Anyway.
Okay. More importantly.
Cleansers. So what do we have? So you're obsessed, yes?
Obsessed.
With cleansing.
Obsessed.
So am I. So. Are these your personal use cleansers?
Yes.
You will be taking off your makeup with these on a regular basis?
And yes, I do. Yes.
So, talk us through some of your favourites, please.
Well, the obvious ones are the bog standards. Look at the state of this, though. Emma Hardy, well used, well loved.
Lovely still smell.
Still love Emma Hardy. Clinique, take the day off. The left-hand side tends to be I'm wearing a load of gunk on my face and I need
right.
to get it off.
Yeah, so I've been
cheating
Clinique,
take the day off. Body Shop Chamomile, which is still massively underrated, I reckon, and has obviously clearly been used by Ava the last time.
Can we all take a moment to pray silence for our long-lost favourite product? I have about three of these left, and I have to ration them for when I'm feeling really, really in need of that kind of lovely comfort. This Clarins Extra Comfort Cleansing Cream doesn't exist anymore. It's amazing. I wish they'd bring it back. The
new
one's not as good.
I've got... Maybe that pot. Louise dropped a pot off for me. Louise Getlippy dropped a pot off for me last week because she doesn't use it. And she heard me moaning about it going out again. And then I have a travel one that I keep purely for when I'm travelling.
Yeah, totes.
Okay. So this is like greasy face. Help me take it off. And it includes the Tata Harper oil.
You're a big Tata Harper fan, aren't you?
I think she makes the best cleansers on the market, personally. If I could only choose one brand for cleansers, it would far and away be Tata Harper.
Interesting.
Nourishing oil cleanser just to get everything off. We could look at this. I'm not even using them in rotation.
And we are both decades old devotees of the flannel.
Oh, look.
There is no reason to cleanse any
other
way.
4 billion flannels.
There's no reason to cleanse any other way. It's the correct way to cleanse.
Completely. Tata Purifying. Then regenerating in the old packaging, which now looks like
that.
This is amazing. It's a bit scrubby. You might like it. It's scrubby.
Oh, well, I like a scrub.
And then refreshing for sensitive.
Yeah.
So, depends on my mood and my skin, how much makeup I'm wearing. And then eye makeup removers sort of here. And this gets actually used a lot more by Ava now because she sort of plays with stuff.
It's funny because I so rarely use an eye makeup remover.
So do I.
The only time I would use an eye makeup remover is if I can't be bothered to get through two flannels because I've got that much makeup on.
I don't wear that much eye makeup, so I don't really bother.
If I'm shooting, though,
don't you?
I love it. Love it. I know you love the balm.
I love the balm.
I love the balm, too. But there are balms I prefer. Mm-hmm. That I love.
Yeah, the balm, I always say it's joyless in a way because...
Doesn't
smell of anything, but it does do the job.
It does do
you
the
know?
Job. That entire franchise, the Take the Day Off franchise, does do exactly
the job.
What it's meant to do.
I love this. I
love
I think it's too expensive, but I love it.
I love carrot butter. It's great on my skin.
Oh my God, it still smells amazing.
It gives good glow, carrot butter.
It really does give good glow. And then this was good until apparently they discontinued it and they're bringing it back. So this is my backup stash. Champney Super Rich Cleansing Balm.
And not too expensive either.
Yeah, I think it was like a 10 or 10 or 12
quid. Yeah, it's not ridiculous. Last ages too.
And then, what else do we have? Oh God, what don't we have? Black Chicken's an Aussie brand that's beautiful products. Great serums. First Aid Beauty.
Yeah.
Great affordable brand.
Great pads.
Easily done. There's like three Take the Day Off balms in there. Tracy Martin Amla is probably the closest I come to a foaming cleanser.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's definitely soapy, but there's no big like bubbles.
Yeah.
You know.
No sulfates in that.
Oh, and I love this for just greasy RMS Beauty Coconut.
I'm really into RMS in the moment because, oh, Quo.
Mm-hmm.
Because often coconut oil smells of nothing.
I mean, they, you know, when I first posted about this, there were quite a few of the usual naysayers saying you can buy a huge pot for 10 quid in Whole Foods, which you absolutely can if budget is an issue. But this has been, and I know it sounds weird, but it's almost like it's been filtered.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really soft and smooth. There's no grit to it.
Yeah.
So that's that. Oh, and I love a bit of this as well. Oscar Micro Exfoliating Balm.
Oscar's great. I'm generally not one for things with grains in, but that's great.
I don't mind a grain as long as it's not a plastic bead.
Oh, well, they're just useless.
They're going to be bent now anyway, so.
I'm generally not keen on grains, but I love that.
And this is one of my favourite eye makeup removers.
It's one of the best products of all time.
£8. You cannot go wrong.
Stain remover.
Everything. This, stain to me, remover. Is what, you know, you'll notice there's no Bioderma.
I have used...
This.
I have used that as a stain remover for about 20 years.
It's also very gentle, just want to make that point.
On silks and on carpets. But that's why I use it, because it doesn't damage your delicate.
Job well done, Body Shop.
Yeah.
And then, bit of Marco. Z Pure Cleansing Balm.
Mm-hmm. I've never used that, weirdly.
Oh, have a play. And, I love this. Alpha H Liquid Laser Cleansing Oil.
Yeah.
Delicious.
Love Alpha H.
Oh, nice bit of Tatcha. Camellia.
Nice.
Lovely. And this is quite nice as well. This is the Diptyque Clay.
It's quite nice. I think it's really nice, and I like the water as well. I was really impressed. How's it doing? I don't know. I hope it's doing well, because there are some really nice...
I think it should be doing all right, and I think it's also doing well because Ruth did a few... Oh, so nice.
Yeah, it smells amazing.
Really good blog post about it, which, you know, a little bit of bloggy support helps.
Yeah.
And then... Oh my goodness. The Nutriganics, which, interesting story, was going to be discontinued. Now, to the power of the bloggers, well, my readers, to be honest,
product.
It's not being discontinued.
Good.
They've kept it in stock. So that is not being discontinued. Oh, another blogger favourite, Oscar Renaissance Cleansing Gel.
Yeah.
Love that too. Oh, Charlotte's Eye Makeup Remover, which I love.
It's just a great bottle, isn't it?
It's a great bottle. And I stroke of genius putting it in a nail bottle. Oh my goodness. Bit of Sunday Riley. This is old though. Charisma Cream.
Yeah.
This is funny. Now, I haven't put this on my face yet because I've put it here to make sure I do it.
Now, I really like May Lindstrom.
Did you try this one yet?
I've got the oil. It's lovely.
And the Blue Cocoon. That's in the bedroom. But
yeah, really nice.
The problem solver is a mask that's apparently so tingly. One of the ladies at Cult Beauty, where I get it from, calls it the death mask, I think.
Oh, that sounds right up my street.
So that's literally literally there for me to be played with. Bog standard for days you just want a bit. And also I get Ava and her girlfriends to use this.
Yeah.
Just because physiological cleansing, it's just a nice, easy.
Yeah.
It's not going to disrupt anything too much.
Roche-Posay, solid, reliable.
Completely. Oh, look, there's the...
The new
one.
That's the new version of the one we love.
Of this. But we don't like that as much. Sorry, Clarence. Oh, God, this is Dr. Barbara Stern, but I kind of like it, but it's a bit too foamy for me.
Never tried that.
Yeah, I don't know if you'd like it. I don't think you'd appreciate the foam. Now, here's my beef. I love it. Where's the pump?
Yeah.
I know they've changed it slightly, but you take the lid off. I mean, it's so sticky because you take the lid off, you go like this, then you have to quickly put it, you can't even put the lid, and then you're everywhere.
Yeah.
But it's a great product.
Yeah.
And again, super affordable.
You would have to get a little thing in Superdrug and fill it up annoyingly.
Suman, which you can tell is boxed because it's got my vlogging notes on it. So I would hold it up, but it has been used. Cleansing gel oil.
God, you're so good. Do you do that when you're vlogging? God, you're so good. I have to just remember it. See, it's all coming out now.
All my tips and tricks coming out. So, yeah, actually, that shouldn't even be in the box because it means it takes longer to get into. Let's throw that in the kids' room. And then, oh, there's some doubles back here. Nothing particularly... Oh, some Ren Evercalm.
I love that cleanser. Love it. Great morning cleanser.
Oh, sorry. Estoderm. Uh-huh. I do like a bit of Estoderm skincare.
I love Estoderm. I have beef with Estoderm though.
Oh yeah.
Estoderm is such an amazing brand. So many of their products are amazing. The packaging is so impenetrable. I don't know how any non-expert can be expected to understand the packaging. Because it's not on counters. There's no consultants, just on the shelf. It's nearly all in French.
Yeah.
It's completely sort of complicated, impenetrable kind of gobbledygook. And inside is such good product that I find it super frustrating.
Super annoying.
Yeah. The hyaluronic range within it's amazing.
Amazing. Lancer polish.
Yes.
Not a fan.
What do we think of the Lancer method?
Not a fan. Not feeling it. Sorry, Doc. Bit too harsh. Bit too scrubby for my liking. Couple of surprises to the readers of my blog, always. A couple of Crème de la Mer cleansers.
The milk cleanser is gorgeous.
The lotion and the oil, which is dual phase, again, pretty. They both work. You know, if Crème de la Mer is in your budget, great. And if it's not, then don't buy it. That's what I always say. I'm quite fond of this.
Yes, Ultimelt.
Soap and Glory Ultimelt.
I've just written about Ultimelt. It's a really, really good product.
I know it sounds weird, but I quite like the packaging. Yeah. It's just like a big fat toothpaste.
Yeah, also a good one for travelling.
Now, and then some scrubbies again. I do love this. Fresh.
All the sugar range.
Sugar range again.
It smells godlike, doesn't it? Yeah, it's like sort of marmalade.
Sugar face polish, rather. Oh, and a bit of Oola. Pure Truth melting.
Now, I used that a lot when it came out. It's kind of dropped off my radar. I must resurrect it.
Yeah.
For me, it's not quite enough for nighttime. And then in the morning, I tend to just sort of rather a milk because that's a bit sticky. But it is lovely.
It is lovely. I tend to put it out as a second cleanse, if I'm honest.
Yeah, I will return.
What else? Oh, come on. Oh, Jane Scrivener. Have you used this one?
Lovely. No.
Oh, smell that.
Yeah.
Oh, such a gorgeous balm.
Really
so
nice.
Jane, that's lovely. She's very English spa-y lady.
So I'm feeling generally balms. A few milks and a few oils, but generally balms.
Generally noisy balms. Yeah. And then I have my travel sizes, obviously. Yeah.
And how often is something graduating to this floor? Like, how often is something going through the testing process and you're going, oh, I'll have a bit of that in my personal stash?
Cleansers, I tend to keep all of them, even if I don't really use... I mean, for example, this one, Cleanser 27, I bought, which I shouldn't have done, but you can tell I haven't really used it that much because it's too much faff.
Mm. You know, too solid.
Oh, it's nice.
It's too solid.
But the result you get, I don't know if it's really worth the faff.
I haven't got time to do all the melting. It needs to emulsify
just melt
really quickly.
Just melt, please. Yeah. I don't want to spend 4 hours.
No, totally melt. And I want it to spread around my face evenly. And
I'm more likely to bring a cleanser straight down and try it straight away than anything else.
Yeah.
Just because it's easy and you only have to use it once to know.
Yeah.
Exactly.
It's like makeup. You know immediately if you like it or not.
But in general, it's kind of greasy, makeup-y face. Feeling a bit dirty, things like this, which is amazing. Just, I've turned Ruth and Anna onto this, and Zoe's using it now. I mean, Tata Harper purifying.
It's too for oilies for me. Yeah.
But you see, I'll use that maybe once a month at that time of month for a few days.
Yeah.
But in general, greasy, oily, balmy.
Yeah.
No surprises.
No.
And that's sort of the working stash. Some of the backups are at the back. Like, I always have a huge one of these, just in case. You never know.
I can't be doing with the microfiber cloth, though.
No, just give me a flannel.
For the win.
Yeah, always flannels.
Right, so that's cleansers. So we are now going... So many, many flannels. we are now going to go into the bedroom because there's a ton more product in there. So we're going to end up in there and have a bit of a rifle through the Muji drawers in there. Right, so we're now in Caroline Hirons' bedroom.
God help us.
And the product is breeding. There is yet more of it. Now, I wouldn't call Caroline Hirons anally retentive or anything, but we'll come back to that later. So we're going to whiz over to skincare because we've just done cleansers, so it seems sensible to go from skincare, and that's what you're known for. So this looks like toners and fresheners.
Yeah, toner shelf, which actually needs sorting because it's too messy for me. I don't like it. But the way I saw it is that, you know, some people will do their wardrobe where they say if you hang everything with the hanger facing one way and then you wear it, you put it back the other way so that anything by the end of the season, if the hanger still means you haven't worn it, you give it to charity.
Oh, I like that.
I know.
I like that.
But with me, it tends to be if anything comes to the front or gravitates even closer here, for example, I mean, this is not going anywhere. It's my P50, has to be done. Then I tend to keep it. So I'm pretty sure that everything behind the first sort of two rows is stuff I need to either move out or I keep for blog purposes or, you know,
so
testing.
You need a cull. You're due a cull.
This is due a cull. Everything else is quite neat, but because this isn't in drawers, I tend to just put bottles on top of bottles and it drives everybody mad. My mother comes in and just goes, oh, can't look at that shelf.
Yeah.
So
here we have a few classics.
We do.
Moisture surge spray got me through two labours.
See, this is new to me. I'd only used this in the last few months.
Ah.
Used it this morning, funnily enough.
Two labours.
Love it.
Perfect, especially to keep it in the fridge. It's great.
There's also the Kate Somerville version, which is very nice. Mm-hmm. The Tatcha version, which is very nice. Aveda, this is probably the first spray toner I ever used. It's not the same one from 1997. It is a new one, but yeah.
I love their liquid exfoliants.
Oh, and a bit of Melvita Pulp de Rose.
Yeah, we've talked about this recently, weren't we? We love a bit of Melvita.
Love a bit of Melvita. So underrated, so affordable.
Yeah.
And I tend to use this actually in a weird place. I use this after my moisturiser to give it a bit of an oomph. Mm-hmm. These can all go here, and then Lush Eau Roma. I think I bought this one for Ava and then stole it, and it's just lavender and rose water. Done. Oh, and then I love this. Now I prefer this to the other one, which is here somewhere. Oh, here. So I like Beauty Elixir in summer, but more just to wake me up.
Yeah,
it's too harsh for me to use every day as a spritz toner. But this, the grape water, is half the price.
It's lovely.
And much more hydrating.
People who love Caudalie love it so much they would die for Caudalie.
Totally.
My friend Julia, whatever I give her, she always wants Caudalie. Loves it.
Sarah's Ink. Mm-hmm. This saved my face when I got back from LA and I had what I would call the scar tissue, as it were, from the allergy. Mm-hmm. The zinc in it is just instantaneous for knocking things on the head. I
great
use
problem
this
solvers,
on the kids. I use it on the boys. Daniel has a particularly the sporty child is football 24/7. So when he gets occasionally gets breakouts or on his back, I'm just literally, well, first of all, I pick. Yes. Mm-hmm. Then I spritz.
God, I love a squeeze.
Oh, yes.
Love an extraction.
Karen's Gentle Exfoliator has to be done.
Classic.
Pixie Glow Tonic again. And then the acid corner, basically. Yeah. So these are literally now one of the few things I just travel with all the time, just for the ease.
I have not tried those.
I have tons. You can take some.
I use Kane and Austin, but they're not in packets. They're just in one thing.
Well, not only does he do these. Oh, you can have I've got a box you can have. He's now done the Medi Spa Peel. So you can do it with this, and then you put the cream on afterwards. Lush.
I'm all over that shit.
Yeah. And then these are extra strength. So when you've graduated from the original, you move up to extra strength. But again, like you say, I love that they're in these.
I think my skin, though, after 40 years, is basically like, thank you, sir. Please, may I have another?
Yeah. And I'll have this and some retinol.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
And then they can come like this or like this.
Awesome.
But I'm so lazy, I'll just take
them. I'm going to report back. I'm going to use these.
No, I'm going to give you a stash before you go. Don't worry. And then Zellens pads for when I'm feeling unglycolic-y, because there's no glycolic in those. Yeah. First aid beauty pads, I love. I think
great.
For the price point, you
I
cannot
think they're
beat.
Fantastic. I've got
my
those
poor bed.
Myself.
Now these, I love. These are 20%.
Totally just love those. There's also a really great Roth AHA body lotion that is awesome. That is one of the best I've tried.
Which reminds me, I didn't pick up that body lotion from the States because we never went back. She placed a special order when I was in LA.
She was too busy filling her own trolley in Targay.
To be fair, I was. Kate Somerville Clinic to Go, tried those. Think you need some of those too. And these are actually my favourite applicator because you shove your fingers up the back.
Yeah, perfect.
Oh,
perfect.
Bliss. That's that
they
one.
They are the best ones.
Bit of Environ AVST.
Fantastic.
Environ for me is hit and miss. Some of the products I think are amazing, some I think. For example, Des Fernandez loves a bit of mineral oil. Don't get me started.
Yeah. Fine.
Bit of Colbert, like you have, bit of Kane and Austin.
Love the Kane and Austin pads. Not as into the Colbert ones.
No.
Straight with you.
No, do you know what my issue is with them? They seem to be a lot of money spent on the packaging. Big glass jar, really, I mean,
small
they feel.
Pads.
Small pad that feels amazing, whereas you've got this, which is plastic, big fat pads.
Yeah, they're brilliant.
It's a third of the price. So that's those. I love a bit of Aesop.
I do too.
Can't go wrong with a bit of Aesop.
Beautiful
the
products.
Original P50. Maramaya's treatment toner that has she brought it out yet? It's just about to come out. She sent it to me to test and then gave it to a load of my readers to test.
I don't think it is.
Sorry, Malika, we'll make sure we know. bit of Lulu, which I know it's not Lulu, it's Time Bomb, but I always think
Do you
Lulu.
You know what's great? Ah, now here's the thing about Time Bomb. I was a really kind of, I was a bit funny about Time Bomb. Mm. I'm going to be straight with you. I wasn't into it immediately. I thought, celebrity skincare, not sure. Tell you what's great. The cleanser with the grains in. Have you tried it? The cleansing cream?
No.
What it's really, really good for. It comes in a tube, so I like a tube.
Yeah, like a tube.
I like a tube. It's got grains in, but they're tiny, tiny, tiny grains.
Oh, nice.
What it's really, really good for is a morning cleanse when you've got nothing to take off. I would not use it as a makeup remover. It's no good, but it gives you lovely glow.
But
and
they
goes,
are my, they're my favourite type of cleanser. The what I call the second cleanse or the morning cleanse are my favourite type.
You'd like it. Coarse mint's really, really good. I've just started using it about a month ago and I'm enjoying it enormously.
Yeah.
And I was a really tough sell on it. I didn't want to know, to be perfectly honest.
And then some ones I just reach for. So when I can identify a bottle from the top and the lid, I keep it towards the back. So
yeah.
Oola mists, again, not expensive.
Love Oola.
Like you were saying about Estederm, love this spray.
Yeah.
But you'd look at it and be like, oh,
see,
what am I supposed to do
product.
With it?
Yeah. That's, that's their hero product. That's the product they're most proud of. And look, there's just no information.
No.
Why?
Sort it out, bruv.
In it.
In it. And then, oh, a bit of this.
Yeah.
Praline. And again, you can't get it here. What is with these French brands that you can't buy
it
here?
At Beauty Mart.
No. Well, maybe you can now. You couldn't literally 2 weeks ago when I was doing something for it on the press. But love it. You know, when in doubt, go to a French pharmacy.
Absolutely.
Which is interesting because when I met Paula Burgoyne, which we were going to talk about, we never got into.
Yeah. We started ranting.
We started ranting about something else, but it very quickly became clear. I mean, she was inspirational to meet, but the things I took away that I thought were really odd is she only does product now. She's only interested in product. So all of the reviews on her website, none of them are done by her.
But they're done by the community.
They're all done by her team.
Right.
And like, for example, she didn't know who Tata Harper was. So I said, oh, you're going to hate me because I love Tata Harper. And she said, well, who's that? And I was like, oh, interesting. So she's now obsessed with making the product and her team do all the reviews. So I always feel like when people compare me, I'm like, please don't compare me. She has this huge team working with her. I'm just trying my best with one face.
I'm really, really happy that she exists. I think, you know, the industry needs people like that. I think she's sound. I think she's great. The reason I often disagree with her is that I've tried too many products to know that you can have an identical list of ingredients in one to the other and they will work in completely different ways. It's about quantity, it's about formulation, it's about carrier oils and things like that. And I don't think you can decide the quality of a product based solely on ingredients.
Just looking at an ingredients list.
Because you need texture. You need all
to see how quickly it absorbs.
You need a certain grade of silicon for me to be happy with it. There are so many variables within an ingredients list that I don't think a product lives or dies by the ingredients list. It's a crucial start, but it's not the end.
Totally. It might be sort of, it might take you to second base.
Yeah. I can't slate a product based on ingredients because one can be great.
But that's what made me think of it because she said during our meeting, oh, don't get me started on French pharmacy brands because of course they all use essential oils, which she hates.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, I love them, typically.
Love an oil. Yeah,
speaking of...
She's a dude, though. I love
yeah, totally. Yeah. Intral toner.
Yes.
Love a bit of Dalfan. This range saved my face from rosacea when I was working in Space NK and my skin just went haywire, had some hormonal... I now know it was probably the sort of pre-area of all my food allergies that came out when I was 40. But Intral, love.
Doing a rosacea column at the moment and there are about 15 women testing products. That is one, so I shall report
Also love the Dr. Wheels.
I love Mega Mushroom.
I love it. Mega Mushroom anything. I think if you've got, again, rosacea or a harsh feeling skin, the moisturisers in particular, as soon as you put them on, you get relief.
They're fab.
Oh, see, now I'm going to have to really have a cull. Mild clarifying lotion. Mm-hmm. People go, oh, you said you hate Clinique and it's full of alcohol. No, it's not. Now, the problem I have with Clinique is that they're different ingredients. A lot of, like, the big brands, as you know, are Lauder. They'll have different ingredients here, different ingredients in Asia, and different ingredients in the States.
So it's hard
so
to
a US
write
reader
post.
Will email me and go, you said you don't like high alcohol in a toner and blah, 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 and you're using this. And I'm like, look, I promise you, the inky is in front of me. There's no alcohol in it. I promise you.
Yeah.
Don't kill me. Kill Lauder, please. Now,
I don't like any of the clarifying lotions, so I can keep it simple.
Couple of more misty things. Pixie Makeup Fixing Mist, which actually is in the wrong pile. It shouldn't be there. It should be this. But the Glow Mist is basically their version of the Pulp de Rose. And it's sold out everywhere. That's fine. Just does the job. Now, essences.
Yeah.
Have you used this one?
Yes, it's lovely. I did a column on essences last year. Mm. And I found quite a few that I really, really, really liked.
But
they are an extra.
They're an extra.
You don't have to go and spend 50 quid on an essence.
No,
give you a nice little cushiony layer. That's what they give you.
Yeah.
They are not an essential. I would be more likely to spend money on a serum or...
Yeah, I mean, when you're going to spend money, it has to be serum first.
Yes.
Always spend your money on a serum. But they are good.
They are good.
If you, you know, sort of the even better range, if pigmentation is a concern.
The Re-Nutri one
And you've got 30 quid. Oh, yeah.
The Re-Nutri
one. And you can just, you know, swipe over. Why not?
Yes, exactly.
So
if you can afford it, do it. It's lovely, not essential.
That's the rather offensive toner shelf. Sorry, Mum. I'll clean it.
Okay, so done that. We've got little family trinkets.
Oh, don't forget this.
What's that?
Santa Maria Novella.
A beautiful bottle.
Rosewater.
Is it just pure rosewater?
Mmm. And it's literally...
Oh, that's lush.
25, 30 quid, 500 mil.
Oh, that's lovely.
You cannot go wrong, but you can only get it in their stores and it's not online. How
nice
rude.
Nice in a bit of water in your iron. Not that iron.
I would not waste it for that. I'm Hello, there's lie, four men lie. In the house. Why would I bother?
Okay, so that's that. Right.
Serums?
Yes, so these are here.
Let me move all these out
of the way.
These are
all Muji drawers. I know this because I have them at mine. So this is the way. If you write about lots of products, the only way to go is Muji, I'm afraid.
So
masses of storage.
I have two drawers for serums, which again, we need a bit of a cull because there's also a crate on that side that needs to be integrated.
Things waiting to graduate.
Yes.
Right, hit the Hirons with some serums.
Oh, God. Okay, so...
Okay, you're obsessed with Zelen serums, aren't you? You always
have
been.
Oh, these two. Yeah, but this one in particular, the new brightening serum. And you're not getting on with it. I love it.
I feel so sad. I wanted to love this so much. It's so far doing nothing for me. But it's only been a week.
Ta-da!
This Sunday Riley Stimulant One has gone, so I don't know
I've
why
got
I'm
one for you
it.
Upstairs.
It's, I think, my all-time favourite serum.
Really?
I think it is, but for a very specific thing.
Right.
For me, if I put this on after exfoliating in the morning, I find I can skip moisturiser altogether, and it has the most... If I'm going on telly, I use this.
Oh, interesting.
Because it has the most instant, oh my God, I look loads younger, my skin looks amazing. Makeup goes on perfectly over the top.
I see, I get that from this one.
So it's not my daily serum.
Yeah.
I have to
Especially
ration it.
Especially now, there isn't any.
I have to ration it, but even if I had loads, it wouldn't be my daily serum. But it is what I use if I need to look great on camera. I would use this before shoots. Amazing. It was about £11 billion, so be grateful it's gone.
That's my favourite.
Oh, I don't know this one.
Oh, it's my favourite.
Is this big enough, do you think?
That's their... They sent me a salon size as a thank you, and I literally would have had their babies as a thank you, because...
Mmm!
Yeah, deep tissue repair is in my all-time top five.
Four, that's nice.
You can use it as a serum or as a moisturiser. I use it as a serum and then put moisturiser on top.
Rich.
Yeah, so that's kind of when you want to do... Old hag, want to look like a young hag face.
I'm going to persevere. I've only been on this a week, so I don't want to damn it too soon.
Ferulic, the usual,
brilliant.
Got to be done.
Yeah.
Oh my God, now these.
Oh, MV. Oh,
and look, all of them. I have all of them.
MV is the most fantastic range
rose
from
Plus.
Australia.
Oh.
They do the most beautiful moisturiser, which is like a rose day cream in a pump that's amazing, and the cleanser's lush as well.
Some Paula's. I haven't used that yet. That's from my last visit with her.
Mm-hmm.
Bit of Oola, Pure Truth Youth Activating Oil.
Yeah, it's a great
I color. Love his... Oh, I've got one you're going to love.
Yes. this is one of my all-time favourites.
That's probably in my top five as well.
I am also putting this in my top five. This is Skin Beauty Repair Concentrate SOS from Clarins. It's just one of those products that does what it promises to do. If something goes badly wrong with your skin, it just fixes it.
People say, but it's so small, but it's lasted me years. One pump, two pumps,
because
done.
The joy of this is that you only use it for a couple of days, then it's worked and it goes back in the cupboard till the next disaster. It's an amazing product. I strongly recommend. This packaging is so much better than the old packaging.
Lauren's kicking my husband's gear.
I'm sorry, I just started that.
I'm afraid Lauren fell into a guitar.
We're a house full of musicians. There's guitars everywhere. Touch of Deep Hydration, you tried that one?
Oh,
you'd like a bit of that. Try that. Oh, is the lid locked? No, there you go.
Ooh, I like the look of it, though. It's promising. Oh, yeah, that's lovely.
Mm-hmm. Your fave, bit of Vichy.
Best budget serum by a mile if you are dehydrated.
Just trying to think if there's anything major in this drawer. The new Hyalamide.
Yeah,
love. Very nice.
Yeah. I used that solidly for months. Really liked it. Still prefer the Vichy, I'm afraid.
And Seminin.
Yes.
Again, talking about Estederm, too much faff.
Too many
products, but the Anne Seminin facial, at the time it was at the Hotel Le Bristol in Paris, easily the best facial I've ever had.
Interesting.
Easily, in terms of how it made my skin look afterwards, purely for the result.
Yeah.
The treatment itself was very French. They left me in the room on my own. There was no attention to detail. It was quite sort of, it was good massage, good effleurage. But the serums, the constant layering of product, and this was years ago, when I was devising the Chantecaille facial, Sylvie basically said, I want you to go and have every facial you can have. I mean, hello, someone's got to do that job.
No.
Oh, sucks to be me.
Yeah,
so while I was in Paris, I took advantage and went to Le Bristol, purely because I wanted to try Anne Seminin in her hometown, as it were. And the layering is what literally made me obsessed with the way I still think.
Okay.
The layering. And my skin,
very certain foundations for your whole
thing. If I'd have had a camera phone at the time, because it was before the time of phones and with cameras, I would have been all over Instagram. And I mean, I can't even tell you the bounce, the fullness, radiance, glow, and that kind of led the way for how I did facials, how I advise clients. So, yeah.
I'm funny with facials.
I am too, don't get me wrong.
I think you're one type of facial or another. Some people like strokey, holistic, lovely, peaceful, nod off to sleep type facial. I want a battering.
Now you see, this is what's interesting. I just had the Kate Somerville facial, which I haven't blogged yet, but I'm going to.
I want to feel stuff happening.
It was very US. No massage. Now I love a massage,
and I
love giving a facial massage. Interestingly enough, my poor husband, I don't think I've ever massaged his feet in my life. I'm not interested in the body, and I've always been that way. That's why when I went to when I was doing my beauty therapy, below the head, I was like, yeah, whatever. I'll go to the décolleté, but that's it. But it was sort of microdermabrasion-y, oxygenating, which was great. Yeah. White light therapy, which was great. But I got maybe 20 seconds of massage when she was putting the product on at the end. And I thought, now, again, I had a little germ of, if I take what they've done with the French way I was trained, put it together. Oh, yeah. That's in my list, Sally. That's in my list.
I like a good beating. This is why I love a Charlie. I like a hammer.
No, I like a hammer. So this is a bit more, those were a bit sort of oil lead at the end. So
a bit more active.
Talk about a good, affordable budget serum.
Yeah, it's a great brand, this.
Merrimaya, great brand. We've already seen that one, so I'll just put that one there.
Great night cream also.
Love a bit of Dennis Gross.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but, you know, I am very easy to read when it comes to skincare. I tend to work with brands and who either have a doctor or a skincare specialist, and it's their forte.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of makeup artist skincare in my bag, as it were.
Yeah.
Who else is in here? Some more Olay. Oh, cosmetics. I haven't really got into that, but I want to. It's one of those weird ones. A few nude products. I do like a bit of nude.
I really like the cleanser.
Serum and milk, but as I said in my blog post, please don't call it a milk. It's a serum. Weird.
Yeah,
few nice Lauder bits. Again, essences. Now, this does give you a glow, but like you said, it's an extra.
Yeah.
You know? Lots of Tatter serums, which I will always say, you know, the Tatar stuff in the UK is, I think, prohibitively expensive.
Proper dear.
Because if it was, it's a bit like Whole Foods. If they adjusted the prices, Whole Foods would be the biggest supermarket in the UK. Yeah. It's amazing.
Yeah.
But it's too expensive. Yeah. You go in there to buy a biscuit and you come out 60 quid later,
yeah.
You know. The serums are great, but if you don't have the budget for them, I'm not going to say to you, you have to get it no matter what the budget. I would rather say, get the Vichy serum, get a good facial oil and massage your skin.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It's mental money.
Didn't get into... Oh, I thought that was Suman. I had Suman's one. I didn't get into it as much as I thought I would, funnily enough. Although, this, again, been discontinued. Perfect, cheap, affordable. I know they like
know
the cheap,
you are.
Affordable. Totally works.
The vitamin C one is good as well.
Yep. Oh, there's the Suman. Velvet Skin Brightening Serum. It was okay, but I didn't sort of rave about it. And I wanted to, because I know people do. Oh, now see, again, discontinued.
That's a great product. I don't know what's happened there.
Why would they do
I
that?
I thought it was coming back. Is it not coming back?
Well, that's what they replaced it with, as far as I know.
Oh, right.
So maybe they will. I don't know. But I love a bit of Pericone.
I do too. Stinks of fish. Works really well.
It does stink of fish. Truth Serum, I recommended to nearly everyone for about a year, because when
it's
you want
great.
Glow, it's just the best for
it's
glow.
It's great, and you can trust Oola, I think. They always work. They always do well.
Tatcha Gold Camellia Beauty Oil is so lush.
I do love a camellia oil.
And it's got the, I mean, I don't buy into the whole flex of oil. Same hand. Oh, sorry. But it smells, feels, core. Absorbs.
Yeah.
It's just, like you say, it's just a core. And I think for here, as far as, oh, more Origins, obviously. Very bit of Bio much. Effect, bit of Tata Harper.
I love Bio Effect, brilliant.
Yeah. The original.
I got Gabby Roslin onto Bio Effect and it's had the most amazing effect on her skin. She loves it, she looks increds.
As you do.
I mean, she does look incredible anyway.
Yeah, how rude of her.
I know.
Right.
She is the healthiest person in the world, though, which has probably got more to do with it than anything.
That's rude.
So,
I.
Right.
Just a few eye products.
Just a few bits here, Caroline. Mm. So you've got Bio Effect Eye Serum, great product.
I love this too, the Lauder Renutrive with the
pearl
tip.
Oh, it's lovely. It's lovely. Great for flights as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, classic.
Classics.
Supreme.
That's probably the one I've used the most recently, but that's the one that actually I had the review on the blog today, the new.
The Hyalamide one.
And it's really hydrating, I find.
It is, but I don't see much of an effect off it, I have
yeah,
to say.
I thought it was okay.
The Zellens is my favourite eye cream.
Da, da, da.
Yeah, it's a great
gotta
eye cream.
Gotta be done, can't go wrong.
Also, I find Sunday's Start Over has an instant effect on me as well.
Yeah, I don't think that's in here, actually.
This, not a high-tech skincare product, but great mixed with concealer to bring it down.
Bit of Revive, but that's the lip one. I tend to throw in a few odd lips here as well. That's really
nice
good for
go.
Brightening that bit. Yeah, usually just the usual.
Yeah.
You know. And that's quite nice, actually. Have you tried that? The renewed one. Nice.
Yeah, open jaw.
That's eyes. And the law is, if this is too bulging, then stuff has to come out.
Yes.
I can't have it everywhere.
You can't have two drawers.
You can't. But you can have three drawers of moisturiser.
Oh, so here we have doubles, I think.
No, this is moisturiser. This is moisturiser. They're two different types. So one will be for combination, one will be for dry, because I'm sick. That's one of my favourite moisturisers in the world.
Oh, me too.
Ever.
It's so nice.
Zellens, always going to have Zellens.
Yeah.
This is really good and affordable for people on budget now.
And gives great glow.
Great glow. The new Muji skincare.
So good.
Big
so
surprise.
Good. I'm doing a whole column on it. Have you written about it yet?
I'm actually doing an event with them next week.
Oh, good. Okay.
Yep.
It's great. I strongly recommend.
Hughes.
Exclusive to Selfridges for a few months.
Oh.
Okay, we became friends over Renutriv. Do you
we
remember?
We did. We did.
So Caroline and I followed one another on Twitter, but like didn't really hang out. This is a few years ago.
Because we were supposed to hate each other, because we're women with different views.
I didn't know we were supposed to hate each other.
Yeah.
Apparently we were. No, I definitely didn't hate her. But we followed each other on Twitter, didn't really know one another. And one day, one of us, I don't know who, was quacking on about Renutriv. And the other one said, oh my God, Renutriv. We both love Renutriv. And then Estee Lauder said, thanks.
Yeah, they did.
Because Renutriv is just like the poshest French butter in a jar.
Oh, but it actually makes a visible difference the next morning.
Amazing product. You put Renutriv on before bed, and it is 11 billion pounds again.
Yeah.
But if you put it on before bed, you wake up. It's just one of those products where you look better tomorrow than you did today.
Absolutely.
Amazing.
This ad is brought to you by Estee Lauder.
Yeah, they were quite happy with this, weren't they?
They were, and we didn't do it on purpose. We just genuinely did.
Just wanging on.
And I love a bit of the creme de la mer,
the gel cream,
and the soft cream. The gel cream's okay for summer, and the soft cream is nice, but I won't use the original, obviously, for obvious reasons.
I like the original.
Of course you do.
Because I've got face like sandpaper.
But you know, the original is. Oh, I love this too.
Oh,
love this.
Amazing. Moisture Surge, I think, out of all the products I give out, Moisture Surge is the one that everyone in the world seems to love. It's a brilliant product, great base, makeup, great masks in that range as well.
Just me taking care of my skincare.
It's just like ramming in the Renutriv there, like some kind of vandal.
And then this, there's no rhyme and reason, it's just two drawers. I love a bit of Charles.
Mm-hmm.
Gorgeous, nice and thick. Hydra Shiso.
Yeah.
Few...
This all feels
a
bit combo to me.
It's a bit lighter, the oil-free. Yeah. And actually, I really love this as well, the Intensive Infusion Daily Moisturiser, Tom Ford.
Yeah, I like the cream
that.
As well.
And then again, budgety, the pomegranate range from the Body Shop.
Good glow.
Go wrong. Bit of Psychoplast.
Yeah.
Actually, I need to leave that out because I'm going to try some Retin A this week. God help me.
Have you never tried Retin A before?
No.
This would be interesting.
Yeah, I know. So I'm a bit scared. A part of me is like, I don't need it. And part of me is like, get it on me now.
It's really good. I mean, it works.
And then Ultra Repair Cream, which I should also leave out. And then some Powerball. Back to Time Bomb.
Oh, it's from Time Bomb.
Yeah.
Yes, I do know that. Oh, I don't have it in this packaging.
I think that's the newish packaging. Bit of Alpha H, Liquid Gold Rejuvenating Cream.
See, that Time Bomb stuff is lovely, I think. Really nice textures. I was a very tough sell on it and I was wrong.
But don't you think it's nice though when you say something about a product and then a few months later you change your mind and you go back and you're like, actually, I've changed my mind.
Happens
you know?
To me all the time.
I used to get grief for it and then I was like, well, would you rather have lied?
Happens to me all the time. I remember one occasion I wrote a really good review about a mask that I really, really, really did love. And then the day the column came out, 2 weeks after I'd written it, I had to go straight into comments and say, no, don't buy it. It made me break out.
No.
But that happens sometimes. Yeah. You love something, you love the effect, and then something bad happens and you break out.
Right, so this is nighttime. Right. Luna.
Yep.
Amazing. Meramia Overnight Recharge Cream is actually really, really good.
Oh, good on a flight,
this
that one.
This is my favourite. Blue Cocoon. Oh, my God.
Mm.
That's perfect for your skin. It basically turns into a grease, but it's so soothing and calming.
Yum.
It's so good.
I love a grease.
And then Bioessence Mask. Bit of retinol. Oh, just
Retinol Reface, brilliant product.
Exactly. I love Bedtime Beauty Boost. Not a fan?
I really, really like it. It's just not enough for me.
You put something
it's
else on?
It's not enough.
You can do oil underneath something.
Oh, well, I always do oil anyway.
Well,
but,
standard.
Yeah. I like an oil sandwich, me.
Lauren, I'll let you put that on because I've clearly busted it. It's fine. It's fine. Have a whiff. And then Paula's Retinol, which is actually really strong. I was quite surprised.
It is really strong.
It's really strong.
It's got a high...
So, not necessarily in a bad way, just strong.
Literally got 800 products on my left hand.
Welcome to my world. Poor Dr. Brandt, but
brilliant.
Great product.
Poor Dr. Brandt.
Poor Dr. Brandt. SkinCeuticals again. Love SkinCeuticals. Advanced Pigment Corrector. Resveratrol.
Really underrated.
Liquid Gold. Old and new packaging because, you know, why not? Oh, bit of Super Facialist.
Yeah.
Again.
Love Una Brennan.
Always got to be done. Bit more affordable. So... That's kind of it for nighttime.
This I had to throw out because it leaks so badly.
Really?
Yeah.
Mind you, it looks like this has as well, actually.
Yeah, it leaks. There's something very wrong with the packaging. And if you're spending 130 odd quid, you don't want it leaking.
Well, quite, lady. Have you tried the Liquid Laser Super Balm?
No.
It's quite a thick balm.
Yeah, well, I like thick. Nice.
Not too fragrant.
I'm drawn here to your body stash because there are lots and lots of parallels here.
Oh, yeah.
So creme de coule I absolutely love. I use creme de coule a lot. That and Clarins Moisture Rich body lotion. But this product here is what I always, always give to brides or tell brides to go and get when they email me and say, I'm wearing a strapless dress and I'm covered. Yeah. I'm covered in goosebumps, keratosis, pilaris on the top of their arms. It just gets rid of it. In fact, the junior fashion editor at The Guardian emailed me about 6 months ago, said, I'm getting married in 6 months. What can I do? I've got these bumps all over my arms. I'm really self-conscious. I sent her some and she emailed me her wedding pictures last week and said, I have never, ever had arms like this. It works amazing.
So I use it for the smell.
Yeah, it smells good. It's
smells
cold.
Like number five.
It's so cold.
It's cold and it smells like Chanel number five
on
me.
Yeah, it's amazing.
So I go from really expensive to cheap.
Same.
And I mean, you'll hate this because it's sweet, but there are days where I love a bit of a Zara body spray. Not even going to lie. So Soap and Glory is always in my body stash.
Yeah, see, your always. Soap and Glory is my Neutrogena.
Yeah, I'm always. And what's missing yet is actually the Garnier Body Repair, the big red one.
Yeah, you love that, don't you?
Love that.
My Neutrogena girl.
Yeah, and there's two drawers of body lotions and stuff in there, but this is the stuff I use every day. Mm-hmm. And I didn't buy this one, but when I get it, I always use it, especially around
the... Because you like the texture.
Well, I like the cooling burn. Kind of wakes you up in the morning.
Yeah.
Nearly out of my favourite fake tan for the face.
Yeah,
gotta be done.
Is so good at fake tan.
So good. This is the hair stash. It's actually, again, this needs a bit of a cull because this is post-LA. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of everything thrown in. So that's face and body. Mm-hmm. Tanning, done. Clinique deodorant, which is genius because it's completely fragrance-free. Loving this. You just spray
Pureology
it.
Is a good
love
brand.
Pureology. So, and that's my favourite hair sort of balm, as you can tell. I think I've got one
I can
left.
See, do you think that might be time to just
no,
quietly say
no, because I'll cut it in half.
Yeah, I'm a cutter too.
Oh, smells amazing. And then, yeah, my anal retentive lip section.
Right, well, your lip gloss mad, so...
There's also loads of lipsticks,
so
don't
many,
worry.
We'll never be able to do them all, but look,
no.
Beautiful. So, NARS... Michael Kors, you love Michael Kors, don't you?
I love a bit of Michael Kors. Some of them might be stuck. Yeah, look. Oh, there's my Chanticleer collection.
Nora Hirons.
Well...
Have you got enough transparent hot pink lip glosses?
Well,
I'm not sure.
See, the thing is that... funny story. Yeah, it's just my favourite. Sorry. And then don't forget my Victoria's Secret stash, which isn't even in that one. It's down that side over there. Yeah, I do like a... Yeah, bit of a lip balm freak.
You can see a theme...
Yeah, basically
developing.
The colours I would wear are also the
transparent
stuff.
Kind of raspberry, strawberry.
Day glow.
Yeah.
Lip fixers. I mean, this is Zellens lab samples that I won't throw out because I still like to use them. What can you do? But your kind of stash is all this side and the other side.
Yeah, see, this is my world. Okay, so lipstick
obviously,
envy.
All of them.
Amazing,
Charlotte.
amazing lipsticks.
Yeah, got to be done.
Poppy King. Yeah.
Michael.
I approve of all of these. The Kate Moss lipsticks are so good, especially
Delilah,
number
Armani,
one.
Delilah, Armani, Burberry, yeah. All the good colours, a bit of YSL, all the lipstick queen. These, oddly enough, compared to how see-through and transparent these are all
Yeah, so if
red.
You're doing a lipstick, you're going for it.
I don't mess about.
Yeah.
I don't do like, a, yeah. I don't do brown because no one wants to look dead.
Yeah.
I don't understand that.
Yeah.
But they're generally
just,
all...
So these are kind of quite full on. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this looks like Envious, is it? Oh, Carnal.
Carnal. Oh, I say.
amazing range.
They're just
I'm a big fan
so
of
good,
envy.
So bright. Oh.
And they're really comfy as well. Good.
Yep.
I approve.
Thanks.
Sanctioned.
Thanks,
given.
Hughes.
Granted.
And then more. Oh, this is
oh,
my backup.
Oh, God, look, there's some transparent raspberry in here.
Because they've discontinued it. So
Would
I had to go in there it? And just, this is my favourite lip gloss ever. So I had to go in and make sure I had plenty of stock. Don't judge me, people. They were, I have to say, they're like 5 for £20. So
yeah.
It's not like I'm...
Fair enough.
Oh, a few nice bronzy, blushery.
Yeah.
This is my go-to. This is my backup.
Yeah, so these are brightening bricks.
Sex on fire. Got to be done.
You dirty bitch.
Dirty bitch. A few bit makeup-y bits. And then this is all... That's my extras. Oh, there's my Charlotte tray.
Yeah.
When in doubt, go for Char.
Yeah.
And then mascaras. I can't tell you, my quest for the perfect mascara is never ending. 3 trays full.
So that's your thing. The looking
Trying
for
to
the
find
ultimate
the right
mascara.
One, yeah. And I've just
I
got...
find mascara the most dissatisfying product. It's one of the most
so
important.
Annoying.
It's one of the most important, but it's rarely right.
I agree. And then there's excess.
Have you got Armani Eyes to Kill?
Don't know, actually. I should do. Now I can't get the drawer back in.
If you don't have Armani Eyes to Kill, I think you need to get some because it's amazing.
There we go. See, everything fits perfectly. There's nothing to see here.
Fine. Okay, you have about 1% of the brushes that
I
have.
Oh, no, this is just what's...
This is just what's
my brushes
show.
Are in there.
Okay.
Okay, that's so my day-to-day makeup.
Yeah, so you don't have to be open.
So I don't have. This is day-to-day. These are my favourite eyelash
colours.
Just checking
for a transparent raspberry lip gloss in there.
Oh, no, they would be here. They would be here. It would be fine. Then this is overflow of powders and foundations and excess and concealers and different colours for when I'm tanned or not tanned, which, let's face it, if it's me and I have a choice, I'm going to be tanned.
Yeah.
And then I have my Chantecaille palettes from of old.
Yeah, there. Collector's items.
My limited editions are stuffed in the wardrobe, well away from prying 13-year-old fingers. Don't even try it, Ava. Mm-hmm. And then the hallway, which at the moment is completely covered in bags and tents for download, pre-packing, is where I have my backups. So this is just the day-to-day.
So
and then the backups are in the hallway.
Good.
Just a few products. I don't think it's that bad. You must have more than this.
I probably do have more than this because I suppose I love makeup as much as I love skincare.
Yeah.
Whereas you're more restrained on your makeup.
You have a double sickness.
I have a and perfume.
Oh no, perfume I can do.
See, perfume I have.
So this
about
is
70.
My go-to. Spray it all the time, everywhere. I'm a sex goddess. Regular readers will be used to that.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm quite
good
at culling
number.
Perfume.
Mm-hmm.
So if I can move, you can't. Even...
It suits you that though. It is really nice.
This you'll have to pan down because I can't even get it open. Jo Malone. Oh, obviously, Frederick Malle has to be done.
Frederick Malle, best
has
perfume
to be done.
In the world ever.
Little. Oh, also. Also partial to a little bit of Flower Bomb when the mood takes me. More so in winter, though. I always find it's a bit too heavy
you
for summer.
You like slightly sweeter things than me.
I like to smell like a sweet hooker.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Yeah. Whereas I like to smell like the inside of an old lady's handbag.
We're so nice about each other. And then the Tom Ford drawer, the Chantecaille drawer. Basically, that's Tom Ford Chantecaille heaven.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, and then I keep, like... Spare body. Oh, that they gave me that as well. That's great for.
I might try
Polaris.
That. I might get some of that.
Spare body. Look, here's the. Got to be done.
It's a great product. That it's just not enough for me.
No, it's not enough
Ameliorate
for me.
Ameliorate is good.
And then this is more body, more hair. And hair. And my favourite hair is Show Beauty.
You do always give good hair. You've always got a good blow dry going on, I always think.
A good blow dry.
Yeah.
I like the saying Nora Ephron said, a good blow dry is a damn sight cheaper than therapy, and that's my thinking.
Yeah. And Dolly says the bigger the hair, the closer to God.
The higher the hair, the closer to God.
Yeah. Very good. Well, just a few bits then.
Just a few to be getting on with.
Well,
this is my cold selection.
Thank you so much for showing us around. I know lots of people were waiting to see it. So
sorry it's
for
not
bearing
as
with us
tidy.
While we battled through.
Yeah.
I feel like I've been into battle.
Well, this is what I feel like sometimes. It's overwhelming. Don't you find it's overwhelming?
Yeah, it is really, really overwhelming. But, you know, you've got a system down. You've got to have a system.
System's not bad. It's okay.
So thank you for bearing with us. I hope you enjoyed it. And thanks very much for watching. See you next time.
Bye.
Bye.